Okay, welcome back to Ocarina of Time. We're going to continue with the quest here. I know I said in the last part that you're going to go to Lake Hylia, but I totally forgot about the item that you need before you go in there. You know, it happens. I mean... Oh, wait, hang on, please. Oops, hang on. Oop. I hope that's right. It's on song, right? Yeah, there we go. Okay, let me turn the TV volume down a little bit. I don't want the mic catching that. But anyway, yeah, I just kind of forgot, and you know, it happens. It's happened. You know, I'll admit it happened. It's happened quite a few times in this playthrough. I just totally forget what I'm supposed to do. It's whatever. I've admitted a couple times I have a pretty bad memory, but people still, you know, flip out like, Octane, you're not. Okay, I knocked the headset clean off my head while getting too into that imitation, so that'll be the end of that. And let me call Epona here. I almost forgot that song, too. It's a little weird on the 3DS version, trying to get used to playing the songs on that. But I like how you can, like, just tap the ocarina to play. It's actually really awesome. Where are you? I definitely heard Epona, but I don't... What do you want? Oh my gosh. I definitely heard... Epona... Was she just, like, refusing to come now? Okay, that's fine, it's fine. We'll just continue ahead. Wait. I heard the galloping. What is going on? Okay, let's just keep going, because this is wasting recording time. But yeah, Ocarina of Time 3D, really cool. I'm liking it a lot. God, it's really bugging me. Okay, but yeah, we're going to be heading to... just like Navi said, we have to head to Zora's Domain. There's a big pearl right here. Those are the ones that you can defeat to get... if you defeat all 10 of them, you get another bottle, but... I noted before, I never got that one, I never bothered with that. I honestly don't think I'm going to be bothering with that this time, either. Oh yeah, I did plant one of those magic beans here, in this area, so we get to see what that looks like. So wait, is this... I know some of these, like, rock circles, if you play the Song of Storms, it opens up a hole in it. Yep, this is one of them. No, jeez. Probably useless stuff. No thanks. There's a green and red potion. I mean, I guess if you really need them, you can grab them, but... Honestly, I never use the green potions. You actually don't really need those for a while. I wouldn't say, because you never really have to use that much magic power. And the red potion, the milk is better. Whoa, I want to stop off here. Oops. Now let's check what's in here. We can go back on that. That was just a fairy fountain. I might actually grab one here. Yeah. Definitely want to keep at least one bottle open for what's coming up soon. Okay. Let me put that away just in case I accidentally use it. No, I'll just keep it like that. Okay, but back to what I was saying, the magic bean that we planted 7 years ago or whatever, it sprouted into that little platform. That's what all of them are going to look like now. Up here, skull tool. Oh, there, right there. I did note before I get into the water temple, I wanted to get at least 30, but it's not a huge deal, because I thought about it. I'm thinking, you know, I have 200 rupees, but am I really going to actually spend them? Wait, no, that's why I skipped that one, because that's probably rupees right there. Yeah, I don't... Off the top of my head, I can't come up with an instance where I'd actually need rupees. So... Jeez, this thing's getting on my nerves. There we go. So, I mean, if I get at least 30, I'll head to Kakariko Village and, you know, get the larger wallet. I actually need to go there to get the big, big quiver, I think. The arrow upgrade. But I was just gonna worry about that later. I should probably do that before I go to the water temple, though. Okay. That didn't take me anywhere. Just took me over here. Wonder if I was supposed to jump off somewhere. But, you know what? Screw it. If you notice, it's snowing right now. And you'll see, I guess, why it's doing that in a moment. See, I wonder if I should have just warped to the force temple. Well, then you know what? I would have had to deal with those moblins. There we go. Alright, so we're going to play Zelda's Lullaby and hop through the waterfall. And we're going to see what happened to Zora's Domain. Even though 90% of you watching this already know what happened. It's basically like, it's going to be like Goron City. It's kind of unfortunate what happened. It's frozen. It was frozen today. Yeah, Zora's Domain is completely frozen. There's pretty much nobody left. I think what happened was everybody's... Oh, wait, no, they're not under the ice. Maybe they're supposed to be, I don't know, but... Zora's Domain is frozen. It's cursed by Ganondorf. Okay, right here... can you melt this with... Let me see if you can melt it with dense fire. I got plenty of magic. It's not a big deal. Okay, well, I lit that torch and broke the sign. I guess that's cool. Might as well light this one. I really like how that looks. I wonder if playing the Song of Storms causes something to appear in this rock circle. I don't remember if anything ever did. Eh. Okay, well, let's continue up. We really don't have anything to do down here anymore. I was wondering what that noise was. It's like, oh wait, I played the Song of Storms, it's thunder. It's not raining, though. I guess the snow is just overlapping the rain or whatever. Hey, all that's left is King Zora, but look, he's... Well, he's frozen today. Alright, so for now... We're gonna help him later. You actually really should. And there's a good reason why. But we're gonna head to Zora's fountain here. See, Jabu Jabu is gone. And... I mean, he... I don't know if this is supposed to be him. This big iceberg, but he's not visible. Crap, I forgot those were here too. Oops! Oh wait, I pushed the wrong thing. I forgot the hookshot's not there anymore. Oops. Okay, stop that. Okay, let's go over there to get that piece of heart, because, you know, just right there. Oh, this might be a little difficult. There we go. Cool. Okay, let's go back, and we're gonna actually head through that big cave. We could actually see this when we were a kid, but it was inaccessible, basically. Another one. I'm just gonna ignore it. Or at least try to. Okay, here we go. Okay, this is the Ice Cavern. This is, I guess you could consider this a dungeon. Basically ice-filled. And the music is actually pretty cool. I like it. It's pretty simple, but it's a nice tune. Oh, watch out for the dropping icicles here. This is a Freezard. If you hit it, oh, crap, this one got me. If you hit it, you want to destroy it before it reforms. This one's moving one. Oh! Ouch. Yeah, that trap's moving fast. Okay. Well, those guys are out of the way. Those guys. Oh, wait, there's another one. Jeez. Alright. There he is. Okay, there's an effect. There we go. Okay, and once all of those are destroyed, we can move on. Everything's either falling on me or I'm getting hit with air, cold air. Okay. At the end of this, we'll be getting a special item. I think we need to collect all these silver rupees to continue. Oops, I missed that one. I like how that flew into me and there was a heart inside, so didn't matter. I'll take that. Alright, that should be, was that 20? Number 28? Yep. Grab this one here. I think this one up top should be the last one. Was there one up here? I thought I saw one. Oh, there it is. Yeah, I knew I was gonna get hit, but I don't really care. Okay, let's find out what's in this room. I hear one of those guys already. I do remember that, I guess you could call the boss of this dungeon is incredibly easy. Oh, shoot. This is an ice keys. Oh, you know what? I should probably use an arrow for this. Okay, I know you're... Yeah, there we go. That blue fire, that's gonna thaw that red ice. There's no other way to thaw that. And where did we see the red ice? The first time? First few times? In Zora's Domain. You can... I guess you can grab two bottles worth. I'll leave here with two bottles worth, I should say. Because you can thaw out King Zora and the shop. But you gotta use it here. So, let's grab some and thaw out that treasure chest. Oh, shoot. There were things like this in Twilight Princess. I'm not sure if there were Freezards as well. Well, let's test this out so you see what it looks like on this jar. But they were incredibly annoying. Oh, it was a purple. God. It's not like I need it anyway. Okay, let's grab some more fire. Oops. Okay. And I thought this treasure chest. I'm gonna go back and actually grab some more blue fire just in case we need it some more in this dungeon. I think this is the map. Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna take a quick look at it. Yeah, it's actually one floor. Not a really big dungeon at all. You know what? I'm gonna free one of the fairies and grab some more blue fire so I don't have to keep coming back here. Just in case. Here, heal my 2 1/4 hearts. I'm missing. Okay, so now, wait, hang on, let me change the items, there we go. Now where are we heading next? Back. Okay, this is a dead end, so let's head back. Actually, I wonder if you kill this last Freezard, if it gives you anything. Well, screw it. I'm just gonna go back. It's whatever. Okay. Yeah, I can't remember if in Twilight Princess those were Freezards or not. I just remember they were really annoying too. If not more. Okay, this right here is something that you need to melt with the blue fire. Yeah, I think this is the only place where you actually get to use the blue fire, this and Zora's Domain or whatever. I guess that's a good thing, because, like, imagine if you had to get, like, a gold Skulltula with, like, blue fire, you had to come all the way back here, that'd be kind of annoying. If I remember right, when I did Master Quest, oh, there's one right there, gold Skulltula. The puzzle for this part was, like, completely different, and it was a lot harder. I've only actually done Master Quest once, and I only got up to the Spirit Temple. Like, I managed to do everything on my own without, like, looking up on GameFAQs or whatever on that game, except for the Spirit Temple. Like, I just stopped. Like, I really did not know what to do. It's about to fire too. And they're annoying. I didn't drop anything, damn. Okay, well, I'm gonna grab. Oh, wait, no. Climb. I'm gonna grab this one. Kill this Skulltula. I'm just gonna put the Ocarina away because I don't need it right now. Okay, I need this one here, so I'm gonna push this forward. Right, I know that moving camera sound is annoying, and I know it's probably annoying you guys, but I just can't, I just want to get the camera centered behind him. I guess push this forward and then. The left? I wonder if I could reach that. Wait, no, that didn't do anything. It's still kind of far. I don't think I could jump over there to grab the blue fire. Oh no, no, it worked. There we go. Okay, and then I'll push this. And then, I know that I don't think that's gonna work. Well, we'll see what happens. Well, Actually, if we push it this way, that's the way out. Forward, I think we'll just push it off. But that'll reset it, so maybe I should do that. Oh wait, no, that didn't push it off. Huh. This might, though. Yeah. I wasn't sure if that rock would stop it. Like, from that angle. I think this should be enough if I get on top of this rock. Oh, I can't. Damn, I can't jump from there either. Geez, this is kind of confusing. I should just push it off and start over again. Yeah, I'll do that. Yeah, there was a puzzle in Twilight Princess in the cave or whatever, the ice area. God, it took forever for me to figure out. I can't remember the exact thing you had to do, but I think it involved a block or something like that. It was just... It's kind of frustrating because I could not figure it out. I mean, it took me a while, but eventually I did, but... Yeah, that wasn't one of my favorite parts of that game. You know, this would be a lot easier if you had, like, an overhead view. Wait, hang on, what if I pushed it forward? And if... see if I could jump from here. I hope not, because this is where I was before. I didn't think I could make it. I just need to be a little bit closer. Try that one more time, see if I can do it from this angle. No. I don't know. It looks like I could grab it, but not quite close enough. Okay, I can't push it back. Let's push this off then. Oh, wait, here. This should do it. Yeah. There we go, perfect. Then I gotta remember how I got to the exit. There we go, perfect. Alright, now I gotta reset this. Nope. Reset. Okay, when I get to this part in Ocarina of Time 3D, I hope I remember, like, all the steps I took. Okay, forward, and then this. I think this just goes forward. Oh, wait, no, it doesn't. You head right off if you do that. Actually, wait, this should be right here. Just push this forward. There we go. Maybe I should have... never mind. I have another blue fire thing in reserve. Let's get the hell out of here. Oh, damn, I didn't think I was gonna get hit by that. No. Okay, sure. As long as you hit them once, they can't, freeze you. Oh, shoot, maybe I should have grabbed some more blue fire. Hopefully there's another torch in here. A blue torch. Okay, this is where we're gonna fight the, boss, in quotes. It's not really a huge boss, but whatever. Okay, It is a white Ulfos. Basically, it's just a big, tougher version of the regular Ulfos, but the attack pattern is exactly the same. Like, blocked it this time. You know what? Maybe it's just the bigger version. It didn't seem tougher at all. Okay, and we, this is the item for this. Or maybe it's the compass. I don't know. I kind of skipped that. Nope. It's in Iron Boots. Okay, so she taught us the Serenade of Water, and that's actually a really cool song, too. I don't remember where this leads. I think it just leads out. Okay, well, can't mess with that yet. Let's go back and grab some more blue fire. Oh wait, maybe... They still blow air when they're, like, half there. Or maybe it's because he was just blowing air already. I don't know. Crap. You know, I'm just gonna go to the big area because I don't feel like dealing with these guys. You know, I never really used the Deku Nuts that much. I could have just used that on them, now that I think about it. Stupid fake jars. Alright. I think it was this way. I think the one room that I didn't go in has a compass. Unless there is no compass here, but there should be. Wait, I'm gonna go back to that one room, because there's a room that I never went in. That room that I never went in. I gotta find out, like, why or how I'm supposed to get there. I need some more blue fire. Too bad there's not, like, a torch at the beginning of the dungeon. I don't know how that missed me. These work. Oops. Get back here. No. Yeah, that doesn't work. Look at that ice case over there floating over there. I know what he's trying to do. Alright, Let's grab some more of this. Might actually have to stop in here again, real quick. Yeah, I think all that's in that other room is the compass. But let's double check, make sure. Oops. You know, this would have been cool if the ice cavern was a little bit longer, but then again, maybe not. I don't know. I don't hate it. No, I guess for what it's worth, the length of it is fine. Oh, there's a blue fire thing in here. Jeez. Oh, that's great. I don't have to keep going in that stupid room. There's a gold skull tool in here, too. I'll take this. Ouch. Look at these keys over here. Yeah, this is definitely the compass. Which is great because I don't really need it because I'm almost out of here. Now, where's that Sculptula? Oh, there it is. Okay, that was that 29? Oh, 30. That's number 30. Okay, great. Even better. I'm definitely going to stop by Kakariko Village before I go into the Water Temple. Might as well just grab this while I'm here. Funny, the compass for the Fire Temple is just still sitting there. Okay, you definitely want to go out with at least one blue fire. Well, actually, you definitely want to go out with one blue fire bottle. Two is just optional. Okay, now that that's done, let's just leave. We're just going to go out the main entrance because we're just going to go to Zora's domain. And there's a good reason for that. Wait, is this the way out, or am I just going anywhere? Oh no, this is the way out, this is the way out. Ah, damn it. This thing had to hit me on the way out, too. Kind of pointless. there's some red ice on the way out. I don't remember if there's anything under here. There's a rupee. I think there's a piece of heart somewhere down there, but no, well. Okay, so let's swim over to King Zora. If you remember, he had been encased in red ice. Thaw him out. You actually get something really cool for doing that. I mean, I would hope so. There we go. Let's talk to him. Zora tunic. Like King Zora said, it allows you to breathe on the water, so it's awesome. You know what, just for the hell of it, the waterfall's frozen, but let's take the shortcut anyway. Yeah, it's not as fun as when you're a kid, huh? Okay, like I said, it's optional to bring two blue fires if you want. You can thaw the red ice in front of the shop. I'll just do that. Still selling the same stuff. Just then hit at the family that was cursed. Okay, so there actually isn't anything left to do here, so we can just leave now. Alright, but in the next video, I'm gonna head to Kakariko Village and get the bigger wallet and probably do that bow and arrow minigame. And then from there, we're gonna head to the Water Temple. So, thanks for watching. See you next time.